Summer is a season of bug bites, so Bryce is joining us now to help stop that annoying itch with some natural home remedies using everyday ingredients you likely already have around your house. And let me tell you, this is a man that is committed to his television segments. Check out the getup.
Ain't no flies on us, T. These are my two favorite camping amenities. One of these electric little shocking pads, and this getup right here, which you can conveniently sort of remove at any at will. And I'm an avid camper, so I'm telling you, I know that these things work.
I love it all. And we could use all the help possible when it comes to stings and bites. So let's go through the top ones that we're going to deal with.
Absolutely. So, and let's show folks what these things actually look like. So bees, wasps, hopefully we haven't been stung by these yellow jackets. They cause a lot of pain. But what folks may not realize is that you should probably take the stinger out. But you got to do it in a very specific way. You can't push down on the little stinger. And you'll see this white around it. That's classic of a bee or a wasp sting. We'll tell you how to treat that momentarily. Mosquitoes, we've all been bitten. You know, of course, they leave this raised, itchy, pink skin bump. Or in rare cases, you'll see them the size maybe 2 or 3 inches wide, and that's a severe allergic reaction. Typically, it doesn't go systemic. Ticks. We have to learn more about ticks. This is an epidemic, in particular across the eastern seaboard. These things carry Lyme disease and all kinds of other co-infections, but their bite, only in 50% of the cases, by the way, leaves a rash that kind of looks like this expanding bullseye. So look for that, and then you need to see your doctor and get tested. If you're unsure how to remove a tick properly, and I highly recommend, you know, a tick removal kit, then please seek out as fast as possible a professional. And then lastly, these are also common outdoors, sitting in the grass, spider bites. These typically cause minor symptoms like, you know, red skin, swelling, and pain sometimes at the site. The classic, though, is two-pronged entry. That's their fang.
Okay, the spider bites totally gross me out because I'm so terrified. But let's talk about remedies, especially some more traditional ones.
Yeah, and most can be treated at home. As I mentioned, you're going to want to remove the stinger if you see it lodged in your skin, wash the affected area, and apply an ice pack, and that'll help to reduce the pain and swelling. There's a lot of topical anti-itch creams, you know, oral pain relievers, sometimes you can use those. Antihistamines, you know, you could be used as, you know, if the symptoms are really uncomfortable. One of my favorite is Afterbite. But this is very commonly available at your local drug food store, or health food store rather, or drug store. But Afterbite no longer uses ammonia, you should know, in the kids' formula, but rather all these natural herbal remedies, and even baking soda, so we'll talk about that momentarily. Here's the thing. You want to contact emergency services or an ambulance immediately if you see a very severe allergic reaction, Tracy. So first up, oatmeal. It's literally this simple. You're going to make oatmeal. That's all this is. Oats, a little bit of water, you put it into the microwave, and then at the end of the day, you're just applying a little bit of that oatmeal to the affected area, because it contains these special compounds that have anti-irritant and anti-inflammatory qualities. You see it used in a lot of commercial products.
Okay, oatmeal's a good one, because most people have oats, but also baking soda. That's something we all have, and you say this can help us with the itch.
Absolutely. So many uses for baking soda, obviously, from baking bread to clearing drains, even scrubbing your sink. But this can also, in particular, provide relief from a mosquito bite. So all I've done here is put a couple of teaspoons of baking soda and then only a little bit of water, enough water essentially to cover the site or the baking soda. And then you just apply that directly to a bite, Tracy. It's so effective. This will relieve the itch in minutes.
Okay, I love that. Now here's one I've never heard of, but we're gonna discuss this now. Onions? What do onions do?
Yeah, well, they bring tears to your eyes. That's for sure when you're a culinary expert as a lot of us pretend to be. But the onion juices that simply leak out of a freshly cut onion, any onion can be used, and you literally just use those juices and you rub those juices to the site. They have this natural antihistamine, anti-inflammatory, and by the way, also antifungal effect. So onions are a very, very useful natural remedy for skin irritation and bug bites, Trace.
And a beautiful perfume if you love onions like I do. I love to smell like onions. Okay, you also say chamomile tea can bring some relief to mosquito bites.
It's making a cup of chamomile tea and then using that tea bag directly to the affected area. Once again, it eases skin irritation, speeds up the healing time. If you've got a you know, a box of chamomile tea or even chamomile loose herb lying around. Again, wonderful option, you know, for all of those bug bites.
You have a cool solution for bee stings, and one remedy is toothpaste. How does that work?
So, you know, any toothpaste will work, whatever you have in your cupboard. It's interesting. We still don't fully understand why it works, but it really works. So if you get a bee sting, honeybees have a very acidic sting, and most scientists think it's the alkalinity found within toothpaste that's going to neutralize that acidic sting. So if that's true, this is not going to work for, you know, yellow jackets and wasps. So you might want to try some of these other remedies that we talked about.
You've got some essential oils that you can recommend to treat bug bites.
Yeah, absolutely. So camphor and lavender, my total go-tos. And you know, you can find these again at any health food store. Even some drug stores are now carrying them. Camphor's related, by the way, to the cinnamon family. And so when you apply camphor directly to a bite, it's gonna cause a counter-irritant effect. It's gonna kind of warm the area and create more blood flow to get over the bite quicker. And lavender, very popular essential oil. Some of you might even have it in your cupboard right now. So this can be applied directly to bites as well. And it's got soothing properties.
Thanks so much, Brett.